Today we're making a clay goat, and I went ahead and rolled out all the pieces that we need for this project. So we have an oval shape for the body, another round shape for the head, four coils for the legs, and three circles, spheres that will be used for the ears, the horns, and the tail. Alright, so starting with the body, I like to take this and place it upside down on the table. And then using a wooden skewer with a flat end, I'm going to hollow out an area where I can fit the coil legs in like a puzzle piece. So I'll take the, I'm just going to pinch these coils into more of the shape of a leg where they can fit. Here as well. Need to open that up just a little bit more. And I'll go ahead and dip this in water, kind of like my slip and score method here. Placing that inside. Go ahead and do that for each one. This one looks a little bit longer, taller than the other, so I'm going to cut a little bit off here. You can blend here as well. And then moving around the back legs. Dipping this in water for the last one. Put that down in there. And then you can look at the length and see if they look about even here. You can kind of pinch to make them longer. Or you can press down from the top to make them a little bit shorter. Okay, so this is looking pretty good. Flipping that over here. Just smoothing out a few areas. And we'll stand this up. Looks pretty good, pretty little. You can kind of press down here to give a little tap so it's nice and stable. Alright, for the head, you're going to roll that into more of an oval shape and then kind of squeezing together with your fingers for the nose here. And you want to just trade hands, making sure it's nice and even on both sides, top and bottom. All right, that looks pretty good. Now, let's see, I'm going to go ahead and create a space here. So I'm taking a small piece of clay for the neck here. I could even just pinch it together, actually, right there like that, from the sides. Up from the front as well. And then here, I'm going to open up a little space for that to fit right there on top. I'll add just a little water here. And now I'll go ahead and make using my popsicle stick. Little spot for the ears on both sides. You see the wooden skewer? I'm gonna make a little place for the horns. Using the flat end, I'll go ahead on each side, press for the eyes. And then using the wooden skewer, I'm just going to open this up just a little bit for a mouth. Alright, now I'll take one of these and cut in half. For the ears, I'm just going to pinch that, thin it out a little bit, round it a little bit. A little bit of water to soften it if needed. And then I'm going to fit this down into the side here in that slit. For the ear, making another one the same size for the other side of the head. And then we'll go ahead and roll a few tiny coils for the horns. Just pinch a little clay here. And I'll dip this in water. I think I like the height of this one a little bit better, so this one I can just off the end there. All right, and we'll add a few little defining features. Smooth any extra slips that I have here with the paintbrush. And the tail. So we'll turn this around. Just pressing down on these back legs to even out the height a little bit. Use this popsicle stick here. And rolling a little coil, pinching that into a half circle, and then on both sides, adding just a few lines with the wooden skewer to make it look more like fur on the tail. Going ahead and dipping that in the water and fitting it right here. Alright, so it's starting to take on that resemblance of a goat here. I'm going to draw just a little line around here for little hooves. You want that to go around the whole leg. There we go. There's our clay goat. And as always, you can come back when it's leather hard and really define your features if you wanted to add texture for fur. When it's leather hard, that would be a good time to do that as well. There we go.